I guess so. This is the Frogmouth Shuttle by Sahb, which is, you know, it's kind of weird because when I look at this ship, it doesn't seem like there's anything too special about it. But on the workshop page, the item is highly rated. So let's see if we can find anything that makes it really highly rated. So the ship is 3763 PCU. Alright, to the side here, we have winglets on actual airplanes. These are for efficiency, I think. They save fuel somehow, but of course that doesn't do something like that on space engineers. Up here, we have a single Gatling turret. And here's the antenna. What are these? Oxygen tanks, armor block. Alright, let's check the bottom. There is a single magnetic plate here, that's great. There is a spotlight here, that's fine. The ore detector is down there, that makes sense. The connector is embedded, that can be a problem. And they have this other connector back here. I personally don't like having more than one connector, but I'm guessing this is for the ship to attach to a station. And this one is for a smaller ship to attach to the ship itself. So I'm not gonna judge that too much. And to the front here, we have a dual access cockpit. So this is made by the same person who made BLB, I think was the name, which has this dual access cockpit design, which is pretty nice. Alright, I think that's the whole interior. Let's get inside now. There's an antenna here, by the way. So there's programmable block here, gyroscope, basic refineries. Oh, that's nice. The ship. Oh, that's nice. The ship has an assembler and a basic refinery. Those will be very useful. There is a gyroscope as well here. Alright, let's get inside. Oh wait, what's this? Hydrogen engine. So that will be handy in emergencies. These are armored conveyors. I like the placement, but I would prefer cargo. You guys know but how I like functional blocks. This is a simple airlock, that's nice. So I'm guessing this is what the programmable block is used for, to show the content of the cargo. We have an air fan up here, some lights, the survival kit is here. Kitchen, I like this interior, it's pretty compact. And like the overall layout in general, it looks pretty nice. There is a basic assembler here. I mean, wait, what? Alright, so the ship has a full-size assembler and a basic assembler. That's an interesting choice, but that's fine, there's nothing wrong with that. To the front, we have the toilet and the shower. Personally, I like the bedroom more than the toilet because it kind of serves the same purpose, but it has more built-in privacy. Like, it has more doors and stuff. I mean, you know, it's not a door, it's more like covering and stuff, but you guys know what I mean. We have a cargo access here, so that's nice. And there are beds on either sides of the ship. Alright, so we have the bridge here. Let's get inside and let's check the internals. So, the ship is hydrogen based. It has a lot of hydrogen tanks, smaller ones. I just checked and that's equal to a single large hydrogen tank. The ship weighs 310 tons. So having that amount of small hydrogen tanks is kind of on the low end, but it's not too bad. I won't recommend going to combat with the ship, but I'm guessing the ship is not meant for combat, so that's fine. Those are the assemblers that we saw earlier, and it has a single basic refinery. It has only two gyroscopes, which is great. There is no reactor, and the only power generator is the single hydrogen engine. It also has three batteries. So overall, this is a very sensibly designed ship for its purpose, which is basic transport. it has some cargo containers, so this can actually be used to transport, you know, a medium amount of stuff. So, if this ship was meant to only transport passengers, I would be very critical about it. But since this ship can actually carry cargo, and since it has production, this can actually be used as a mobile production base that is very cheap to build. You're not gonna be able to build everything because you don't have a full-size refinery, but having production certainly helped making this ship a lot more useful. Because, you know, if the ship was meant to only transport passengers, then it would be kind of pointless. But since it has all this production and the cargo capacity, it's actually a pretty decent ship. Alright, so the ship doesn't have a jump drive, meaning that this is only a planetary ship or lunar, and it possibly needs to be based on a mothership if you want to carry this to different planets. Which is fine since the PCU is very low, and if you really want to add a jump drive to the ship, you can easily add one back there. Alright, let's fly the ship now. So the ship has like 8 upward hydrogen thrusters. Let's confirm that. Alright, so it has 8 upward hydrogen thrusters. That's about 2.6:1 thrust to weight ratio. So this should be able to fly in atmosphere, I mean on planets, and it should be able to dodge really nicely. Let's try now. Oh yeah, I can. It accelerates really quickly, and you have a lot of forward thrusters as well, so this can easily dodge enemy fire. And even with only 2 gyroscopes, you can really turn really fast with the ship. So that's nice. It actually feels like an airplane. I like it. Alright, let's fly this on the planet now. There we go. Alright, and because this has dual access cockpit, you can actually access the ship from the outside, which is pretty handy. So yeah, I'm actually pleasantly surprised with the ship. Like, there's nothing too wrong about it. Oh, let's check the H2 generator, by the way. So it has 3 H2 generators, which is not bad at all for the amount of hydrogen tanks that it has. So yeah, this is a very sensible ship. I'm having like a hard time trying to think what might be a negative about this ship. Oh, if you look at the thrusters, they kind of look like fighter jet thrusters, by the way, so that's a nice touch. So I guess maybe it could use a full-size refinery, because at this PCU range, I can actually fit in a full-size refinery, if you remember my submarine. But again, that's pretty nitpicky, and overall, this ship is very, very sensible, which is again very surprising because I was kind of expecting this ship to be poopy. Alright, let's crash the ship now, because you know, these types of passenger ships, they usually don't make sense, because you're spending a lot of PCO to transport people, but that's not the case with this ship. Alright, let's do something interesting. I'm gonna crash on the side, like, you know, you're trying to go up and oh no, we're safe by the trees. Hold on. Alright, here goes. Oof. Oh. Very nice. Let's check the damage. Alright. I was checking the Steam Workshop page. I need to stop forgetting these ships' names. So, that's the Frogmouth Shuttle by Sahb. You can find the link in the description. Bill.